Welcome you all. In this video we will see an example to design a FAR filter using rectangular window. Here we are going to design a low pass filter using a rectangular window technique. For that, the passband gain is unity and the cutoff frequency is 1000 Hz and this is working at a sampling frequency of 5 kHz. The length of the impulse response should be 7. Now we will see how to design a low pass filter using a rectangular window. Here the cutoff frequency is given as 1000 Hz and the sampling frequency is given as 5 kHz. From this we can determine angular frequency, which is equal to 2 pi into the cutoff frequency divided by the sampling frequency, which is equal to 2 pi into cutoff frequency is 1000 divided by the sampling frequency is 5 into 10 power 3 Hz. So the desired frequency response of the low pass filter is given like this. Here the frequency is varying from minus pi to pi. So from minus 2 pi by 5 to 2 pi by 5, the response will be equal to 1. All other cases, the response will be equal to 0. We have to design a filter based on this. First, we are going to determine the filter coefficients HD of N from the desired frequency response. HD of N is given by 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi to pi HD of e power j omega, this is the desired frequency response, multiplied by e power j omega n d omega. From the given specifications, for the range of minus 2 pi by 5 to 2 pi by 5 only, the response will be equal to 1. All other cases, it will be equal to 0. Integration of e power j omega n, which is given by e power j omega n by j n, which is ranging from minus 2 pi by 5 to 2 pi by 5. In this step, we are applying the upper limit and the lower limit. E power j theta minus e power minus j theta by 2j is represented as sine 2 pi n by 5. For n is equal to 0, we have to apply L'Hospital's rule. So HD of n is equal to limit n tends to 0. We have to differentiate the numerator separately and the denominator separately. When you are applying the limit n is equal to 0, this term is cos 0 multiplied by 2 pi by 5 divided by pi. So HD of n is equal to sine 2 pi n by 5 divided by n pi. If n is not equal to 0, it is equal to 0.4 when n is equal to 0. Now we have to determine the windowing sequence. Here we are going to use the rectangular window. Here length of the windowing sequence is given by n is equal to 7. So the windowing sequence is equal to 1 if n lies between minus 3 to 3, 0 elsewhere. Now we are going to determine the finite filter coefficients, that is h of n. For converting infinite impulse response to finite impulse response, here we are going to use the windowing sequence. For n is equal to 0, we already determined h of 0 is equal to 0.4. For n is equal to 1, h of 1 is equal to hd of 1 into wr of 1. Hd of 1 is sine 2 pi by 5, n is equal to 1 divided by pi. The windowing sequence is equal to 1. So which is equal to 0.3027, which is equal to h of minus 1. Since it is symmetric. Similarly, for n is equal to 2, h of 2 is equal to hd of 2 into wr of 2, which is equal to 0.0935. Since it is symmetric, h of 2 is equal to h of minus 2. Here we have taken the windowing sequence from minus n minus 1 by 2 to plus n minus 1 by 2. So the transfer function h of z we have taken as, which is equal to h of 0 plus summation n equal to 1 to n minus 1 by 2 h of n into z power n plus z power minus n. Here capital N is equal to 7. So 7 minus 1 by 2 is equal to 3. So summation is varying from n is equal to 1 to 3. We already determined the values of h of 0, h of 1, h of 2, h of 3. So h of 0 is 0.4. When n is equal to 1, h of 1 that is 0.3 into z power 1 plus z power minus 1. When n is equal to 2, h of 2 is equal to 0.0935 into z power 2 plus z power minus 2. And when n is equal to 3, h of 3 is equal to minus 0.0623 into z power 3 plus z power minus 3. Here we are having z power positive terms which is not realizable. So next we are going to determine the realizable transfer function. To convert the transfer function to a realizable transfer function, we are going to delay h of z by n minus 1 by 2. So we are going to delay by 3 units. So z power minus 3 multiplied by h of z. So h of 3 is 0.4, h of 2 and h of 4 is 0.3027, h of 1 and h of 5 is 0.0935, h of 0 and h of 6 is minus 0.0623. So these are the causal filter coefficients. Now we can realize this transfer function using linear phase realization. We know that h of z is equal to y of z by x of z. So y of z is equal to this h of z term multiplied by x of z, which is given like this. Now we see the linear phase realization for this output term. So y of z we are going to determine. Here we are having the maximum of 6 delay elements. So we are first drawing 6 delay elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 delay elements. Here first term is x of z. This is x of z. Plus x of z is delayed by 6 units. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 units. So these two are added and is multiplied by the filter coefficient minus 0.623. It is multiplied by this term. This is added with, when you are taking this term, here x of z is delayed by 1 unit. X of z is delayed by 1 unit. Added with x of z delayed by 5 units. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This output both are added and is multiplied by the filter coefficient 0.0935. Next term, x of z is delayed by 2 units. X of z is delayed by 2 units. That output is added with x of z delayed by 4 units. 1, 2, 3, 4. These two outputs are added and is multiplied with the filter coefficient 0.0327 and is added with, here x of z is delayed by 3 units and is multiplied by the coefficient 0.4. So all the outputs are added, which provides the total output for this y of z. Thank you for watching this video.